Hey guys, what's going on? Brother Cody here again for another week of Children's Church. Still doing it on YouTube. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Hope you're having a great week. Anyway, let's get started. If you have a Bible, go ahead and turn to 1 John 1, verse 9. 1 John 1, verse 9. And as you're making your way, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about sin. So I was doing some painting earlier, and I noticed that I had this brush. Now, do any of you guys like to paint? Brother Cody does not. I hate painting. That's a very strong word, and it's very true. Paint gets everywhere. I'm not very good at it, but with this new house, we're doing a lot of it. Painting walls and trim and everything you can imagine. I've done enough painting for an entire lifetime, and there's still a lot more to do, so that's great, right? But anyway, I noticed this real cheap paintbrush, and as you can see, the paint has really dried in it and got real hard. Listen to this. That's how hard it is. Do you guys think that you can paint with this? I think it'd be pretty hard, right? When dry paint gets on the brush, it gets real hard like you saw. And when you go to paint and do your brush strokes, you can't really get nothing done, right? And that can be a lot like sin in our lives. We'll let sin come into our lives. And before we know it, it'll start accumulating, kind of like this dry paint is on this brush, right? Before you know it, it'll start accumulating, and it'll be so much that we can't do anything good for the Lord anymore. So we can't be effective in painting. So if I were to go and try to paint a wall with this brush, it probably wouldn't do anything. It'd probably be some abstract painting. And that just means it's kind of a little funky looking. There's grooves, and it'd be real texturized. It wouldn't be very good. And that's the same thing with sin in our life, because if we allow sin to pile up and pile up, when we try to do things for the Lord, we can't, because all that's left behind is the sin in our life. That's what gets shown when we're trying to do things for the Lord, but we're just filled with sin. And that's the same thing with this paintbrush. We can't do nothing effective with this paintbrush when it's dried up and gunked up with, you know, the old paint. And it's just kind of powderized. You see it kind of floating off when I brush it. So that's kind of the same thing. And we become useless to the Lord when we let that sin build up in our lives, right? So the good news is that we can always be restored back to the Lord. That fellowship with God, we can always ask for forgiveness and restore that fellowship with Him. And that's great news, because Brother Cody has had to do that plenty of times. And I'm sure if you ask your parents and grandparents, whoever it is that you talk to, they will tell you the same, that we've had to call on the name of the Lord, ask Him to forgive us of our sin that we've been living in, and restore that fellowship back to Him. So grab your Bible. 1 John 1, verse 9 says, "If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." So that's a great verse. That's a verse that Brother Cody had to memorize, just because it's so meaningful to a Christian in their daily walk with the Lord, because we can come to the Lord with anything and ask Him for forgiveness. And no matter how dirty you may be, just like this paintbrush, no matter how dirty and filthy it may get, it can always be cleaned. There's this stuff called mineral spirits. Brother Cody has had to buy a lot of it to clean all these paintbrushes, because paintbrushes are not cheap, and I have to clean them so that I can use them again. And so there's this stuff called mineral spirits, and you soak the brush in there, and with enough cleaning and with enough scrubbing, this brush will be good as new, and we'll be able to use it again effectively, where it won't just bulk up and paint will just be in globs. It'll actually brush the paint on perfectly how you would want it. And that's the same thing with Christians. We can call on the Lord, ask Him to forgive us of our sin that we've been living in and committing, and he will do that. The Bible says he casts our sin as far as the east is from the west, so he never remembers it again, which is a blessing to us as Christians, and it's just a great thing because we can be a clean vessel and we can start serving the Lord again with full power, full steam ahead, and being efficient and effective in serving the Lord and doing that. So I want to ask you today, no matter where you are in your walk with the Lord, if you've been living in sin, if you strayed away, you can restore that fellowship back with him. Just call on his name. If you turn over to Psalms 18, verse 6 is a real helpful verse. It says, "In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried unto my God. He heard my voice out of his temple, and my cry came before him, even into his ears." So isn't it a great thought that no matter where we are, if we'll call on the name of the Lord, he will hear us. There's no point as a child of God that he won't hear our cries back to him if we're, you know, calling out to him. So that's a great thought. He always wants to hear about your struggles that you're going through. He wants you to ultimately give those struggles to him so that he can help you and, you know, help you overcome those struggles. So what a thankful, I'm just thankful for that. And it's a great thought to think about that we have a God that wants to have that close fellowship with us and does not want us to have sin in between he and us in our walk with him. So maybe you don't know him in the free pardon of sin. We've talked about it in the past weeks, the ABCs of salvation. I keep bringing it up because number one, it's so important. And number two, it's so easy to understand. Admit, A for admit. We have to admit that we're sinners. If you don't know it by now, we continue to struggle as humans because we have that sin nature in our life. We mess up, we fail God, we fall short of his standard. And the Bible says, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God," in Romans 3:23. So the best we can do still comes short of God's holy standard that he sets for us. So that's A, we have to admit that we're a sinner. B is believe in Christ. John 3:16, "For God so loved the whole world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." That is great news today, that there's even a way at all. And that way is through Jesus Christ. He made a way. He paid the ultimate price for us on Calvary. He died, as we talked about last week. He paid that ultimate sin debt so that we, as a humankind, you know, all the human race, if we would trust in that sacrifice that he made, we could have our sins forgiven, pardoned, and we could be reconciled back to God. What a great thought that is. So that's B, believe in Jesus. And C, confess. We have to confess our sin. The Bible says in Romans 10:9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So we confess that Jesus is our Lord, ask him to come into our heart, and we can have that full relationship with him. Like I said, be reconciled to God. And be able to call on him anytime we need help, when we're struggling with that sin that does so easily beset us, as the Bible says, we can call on him and he will hear us, as that verse said. So encouraging verses tonight. Just a thought that I had on how even though we can be dirty and ineffective for God, if we will call on him and restore that fellowship, we can be cleaned and go on and be efficient and effective in serving him going forward. So let's pray, and then I'll see you guys next week. I hope you have a great week, and we'll hopefully see you soon in Children's Church. So let's pray. Lord, I thank you so much for allowing us to gather again. It's been a great past few months doing Children's Church this way, Lord. Even though we kind of have a minor hiccup not being able to meet physically, Lord, I'm thankful that we have the means to be able to do this through YouTube and, you know, through video. And I just thank you so much for that. I ask that you would bless our church, Lord, put a hedge of protection around it and our pastor and his family, Lord, and just continue to help us grow, help us to spread the gospel to a lost and dying world. Even when those days that maybe we're scared or shy, that we would be able to think back on what you've done for us, Lord, and the ultimate price that you paid for us, and be able to share those things with a lost world, Lord, and just help us to give us boldness, give us a backbone for you. And I just ask that you'd be with all the ministries this week, Lord, as they prepare and study, Lord, and prepare to share your word. And I just thank you so much for what you did at Calvary. We love you, and we thank you in Jesus' name that we do pray. Amen. All right, guys. Have a great week again, and hopefully we'll see you soon. Bye.